Hello?
There you go.
You've been a career musician for a while. How was doing the music for Steven Universe and working with the music team different from your experience with Ali and AJ and other projects?
That's a good question. I think for my own music, it's always been a really intimate experience because it's always been written from the ground up by my sister and I. And we'll collaborate with some people every now and then, but a lot of the material just comes from us. So I love having kind of my finger on the pulse at all times creating. When it comes to Steven Universe, it's Rebecca's creation, which I love. I never enjoyed singing someone else's song so much. I'm so close to singing my own material, and I truly love her songwriting. I think her style and just the way she phrases certain things and even her tone as a singer is really interesting, and I love being able to voice her work, because as an artist, I don't really get to do that. I'm constantly doing my own project. So I love it. It's very different, and I love the songs she's written. So I'm really able to work with an incredible artist.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hi. Do you know if there's going to be any new songs with Stevani coming up?
Yes, there is actually a Stevani Connie song coming up. So I hope that was okay to give away, and that's all I can say. And here. But don't spread that word too deeply. So yeah, you'll hear a new song pretty soon.
Hi. What is it like having two different kind of people in you? Like, what is it like to be two different people?
Yeah, no, it's a good question. I love it because one of my best friends is Mel, and so I feel like if we merged together, we would create something as incredible as Stevani. And I truly feel like the foundation of friendship is so important in this show, and I think Steven and Connie merging together really kind of says it all. I'm sure all of us have that one friend that we would love to fuse with. And it's really neat. I mean, for me, my voice is a bit androgynous in some ways, and so I think I don't really have to alter how I sound. I pretty much sound this way for Stevani, as you guys know from hearing it. So I'm kind of able to just take what I hear from Zach and what I hear from Grace, who play Steven and Connie, and I take their laughs, I take their mannerisms, and just kind of their intonation, and I make it my own thing. And from there, I try to combine the two as best as I can, and hopefully I've done a good job of that. But it's really been challenging as a voice actor, and it's my first job as a voice actor I've ever done. So it's been a really neat challenge to kind of play the merging of two different people and two different sexes.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hi.
Okay.
Yes.
How are you?
Out of all the episodes that have aired with Stevani so far, which has been your favorite to a voice?
Probably Beach City Drift. I love that episode. And I think there's just something about it, just the empowerment of her, racing that car. It's like she finally gets her moment to shine, and I just feel like she's kind of able to just express herself in a really cool way in that episode. And there was something about working with the cars and the noises of the tires and the screeching and seeing like the animation before I was able to actually record it, just the animatic, was really neat, because I feel like I felt the energy of being in a drag race, and I don't know what that's like, but I feel like that episode brought me into it in a really cool way, and I think that episode's probably one of the most visceral ones that Stevani's in, just because it's so just tangible. Those vehicles just feel real, and the sound, and the look of them, and I'd say that's probably my favorite Stevani episode.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hey, how's it going?
Hi.
So I'm kind of curious about the casting process for this, because something like, all right, we're looking for a voice actor whose voice is kind of halfway between these two children is kind of an interesting thing. So I'm kind of curious, how did that go?
That's a really good question. It came about in a really random way. They actually couldn't find the role for a really long time, and I think it's because of that. It was like finding someone that can play Steven and Connie and figure out how to mesh them into one. I actually came in for the casting director because I had started doing voice auditions. It was something I was really passionate about, and the casting director brought me in for something that was totally unrelated to Steven Universe, And after my audition, she was like, hey, I really think, you know, the tone of your voice is right for something else on casting. I work on a show called Steven Universe, and we're really trying to find this character that's a fusion between these two roles. And she was like, I can't really give you too much information, but I would love you to just record a couple lines and just see how it goes. And I did, and they brought me back in for Rebecca, and I ended up booking the job. But it was really one of those things that was kind of accidental through another audition that I just slipped in for. So it was really a cool process and kind of accidental.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
You said that you have a real passion for voice acting now that you're doing that, but you started out as a musician. I have a couple of questions that you can put together.
Yeah.
First of all, do you consider yourself more of a musician or more as an actress? And would you say that now that you've discovered voice acting, that has kind of taken over that? And how do those two things tie together for you?
You know, it's interesting because they both bring so much joy. Like, I really get a gratification from both that is really hard to explain. I think with music, it's instant. You know, when I'm touring with my sister or I'm playing a live show, it's like that instant gratification you get from the audience, there's nothing like it. Being, you know, on a film set or in a recording studio, you don't really get that, even though it's fun and you're working on something that no one's seen or heard yet. That's the exciting part, but you're not getting that live thrill that you get from performing. So I do really consider myself both, and I love both. Music is probably the first love, just because it does involve my sister, and we're so close, and we've been writing music for so long that I feel like the creation of a song is probably the coolest thing that I can contribute to the art space. But in regards to voice acting, I love it. I think for me, I love mics. It sounds really silly, but ever since I was little, I grew up like pretending things were mics. And like even this, like my sister's different, like she'd be back here. Like I'm just like, there's a mic here, I wanna talk.
As a musician, I understand, I started singing at 5, so.
Yeah, there you go, and even the way you're holding it, like yeah. You're either kind of wrapping the cord around a certain way. Like, no, it's true, like it's interesting. And so for me, like I love it. And I think being that I'm so comfortable singing, it's brought me to a really comfortable place voice acting, because I'm so used to dynamics of a mic and, you know, whether you get really close and intimate or whether you get far away. And for me, I think the two are really blended together in a really cool way. And I'm working on a new cartoon, my second cartoon that I've ever done. And I'm able to go in and work on a really cool character that's totally different from Stevani. It's a show that hasn't been announced yet, but it's a really neat role for me because I'm actually able to be like really aggressive and in your face, and like I feel like Stevani is really sweet but super confident, so they both have these similarities but they're also both very different, and I'm able to really play with the mic in that way, so it's cool.
That's awesome.
Thanks. Yeah.
Hi.
I have two questions, the last one's really quick.
It's okay.
We've got plenty of time.
Yeah, that's the way.
When you were like filming for Mindful Education, like then here comes the thought, it sounded like you had a lot of emotion in it. Did like that connect to you anyway personally?
I think so, yeah. I think the whole thing of like Connie feeling like she made a mistake or you know, bullied someone in a situation or just felt horrible, I understand that. I mean, for me, it's like you can come across a certain way and not mean for it to be that way, but then someone took it in a way that was negative and you're like, I want to fix this, I want to erase it. And I just feel like that song is a really interesting statement and a great lesson, just to be mindful about how you treat people. And I just feel like for me, that song in a way felt like a song that I had written, because when I was singing it, I truly felt an emotional connection to it. And I think that's what Rebecca brings to songwriting, is that it's really personal. And so singing that song for me with Estelle was really cool. And already coming from an episode like Alone Together, where, you know, it was the first time we ever saw Stevani, and then doing something like Mindful Education where I'm able to sing, I didn't even know my character was gonna sing. So it was a really neat introduction to Stevani singing.
And my other thing is, can you say it's Stevani, I am not your baby?
Totally. All right. It's Stevani, I am not your baby.
Hi,
What's your favorite line in Steven Universe, just to say?
Oh, that's so hard. The one that comes to mind is probably the first time I discover what I just did with Steven and Connie. So it would probably be Alone Together when she's washed up on the beach and she's like looking at her feet for the first time and like her eyes are blinking and she's like becoming like this form that she didn't know she could even take on. So for me, it's, I'm a fusion. That to me is like my favorite because it's just the best discovery. It's like, little did Stefani know that this would happen.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's so weird hearing you like say these lines mm-hmm. that I've like heard it, you know, several times.
Totally.
I've watched the show several times and it's like, I see you in person and it's
yeah.
like a different, you know, and you sound different and then you say her lines, it's like, oh my gosh.
I know, it's so weird.
Hi. I have a question. Okay, here it is. What is your favorite episode that you've seen?
That's really hard. I mean, I love anything with Lars. And I love Lars and Sadie's relationship. I just think they're an adorable duo. I think they could have their own spinoff and it would work.
Yes.
I also love Onion, so probably Onion Gang, even though it's like super weird and bizarre. I think that episode is really cute, and I just think Onion is like the most original little character on television. Like, just bizarre. What is he? So probably Onion Gang if I had to choose, just because I love him. But that's a really hard one. I have one that I know is going to be my favorite that's coming up that hasn't aired yet. I know, I'm sorry.
I'm going to like tweet at you as soon as the episodes have aired to be like, okay, so which one was it?
I know it's a really simple question, but what's your favorite character and why?
Oh, that's a good question. Honestly, I would have to say Pearl. I just love my mother who she is. She's just kind and strong and powerful and, you know, obviously like a little naive to earth and she definitely has a groundedness to her that I love, but you can totally tell she's from another dimension. And it's like her being around people that are from Earth, it's like, whoa, this girl does not really fit in. This woman just is on another level. But that's what I love about her. There's just something about her that is so just kind and sweet, and she kind of reminds me of my mom. She's just caring, and I just think that character's really endearing.
Thank you.
Yeah.